Welcome to the eAcademy. In the previous episode, we discussed the INT-TSH2 keypad interface. This time, I will show you how to configure this device and prepare the design of the interface. The Integra 128 Plus control panel that I will be using in this episode is already pre-configured. The INT-TSH2 keypad has been connected to it and is identified. At present, it only has factory settings. The control panel is connected to the computer. Let's go to the DLoadX program. I open the structure window and select the hardware. I expand the list of keypads and select INT-TSH2, then go to the right side to the keypad data tab. I read the data from the keypad. I select the screen tab. This is where I will be able to change the interface settings. So I'll start with the color theme. I choose the theme tab. More than 20 preset themes are available to choose from. One comment at this point, when switching between the color themes visible in the list, we only browse them. In the selected theme field, the name of the theme that was previously selected is still visible. To actually select one of the listed themes, choose and highlight one of them, and then click Select. Next to the name of the selected theme, you will see what color of the font and icons are used in it. The second color applies to the same elements, but when they are highlighted, e.g. when touched. In the last field, we see the name of the image used as a background. The background color is also indicated, which will be displayed, e.g. when the graphic just mentioned is not loaded. If we want to create our own color theme, we should go to the last item on the list. Choose Custom and click Select. Okay, I will now try to change the color composition. Alright, for the purposes of this episode, I'm going to use one of the factory preset themes. Now I can go to the Screensaver Settings tab. I have just selected a color theme that will be applied to the interface design of our keypad. However, if I uncheck the Use Theme option, I will be able to indicate on my own what colors of elements will be used on a given screen. In this case, on the screensaver. I can also change the background image. I can choose the image according to the previously selected theme. The background graphics of the other themes are also available. I can also use other image from a JPG or BMP file. If we want this graphic to be displayed on the keypad screen after configuration is complete, it must be saved to a memory card, which will be inserted into keypad slot. One comment. If we change the background image by setting a graphic other than the one from the currently used theme, we will no longer be able to use another custom image at user screens. So we will only be left with the choice between the background from the theme and the graphic we just discussed. By default, in the middle of the upper part of the screen, there are four icons indicating the system status. As in other keypads, they are responsible for troubles, armed mode, service mode, and alarms. In the middle, you can see a large clock, and below it, a field with a date. One comment. While the field defined as date time is an element which can be modified, the clock located in the center of the screensaver cannot be removed or changed. All right, with other elements, can we place here? Let's check the list. The first one is text. With it, we insert a text field on the screen. We can enter any content, choose the color, and one of the three letter sizes. The next one on the list is partition state. Here we can indicate which partition this indicator is to refer to. Three sizes of this element are available. In the case of zone state, first of all we have to indicate which zone the item refers to. We can then select one of the three widget types, indicator, text, and icon. In the case of text and an icon, we can also decide how the widget should look in the case of a normal state and violation. As before, we can set one of three sizes. Next, we have the output state. The available options and widget configuration are very similar to those for the zone state. The next widget is temperature. Specify from which zone its value will be taken. You can choose the unit, degrees Celsius or degrees Fahrenheit. As before, you can also choose from three widget sizes. After temperature, there is date time. It is this widget that can be placed on the screen below the clock by default. By changing the notation in the format field, we can customize how the date and clock indications are displayed. And so the lowercase d letters stands for the day, the uppercase m the month, and the lowercase y the year. Depending on how many letters you place in a sequence, the format of the date will change. For example, days may be written either numerically as consecutive days of the month or in words as days of the week. On the other hand, the lowercase letters h, m, and s stands for hours, minutes, and seconds, respectively. Last on the list is the rectangle. Using it, we can, for example, add a background to another previously inserted widget. In addition to the size, we can change the color and thickness of the border, as well as the color and transparency of the fill. When the elements have been arranged on the screen, we can change their order in the field on the left. This is especially important in the case of overlapping elements. In this way, we can, for example, place a colored rectangle under a selected widget to make it more visible. Okay, these are all the elements that can be put in the screensaver. In the previous episode, we said that the screensaver can be displayed interchangeably with the slideshow. To make this possible, you should first prepare your favorite photos or other graphics that will appear periodically on the keypad screen. They should be saved in BMP or JPG format, and their resolution must be the same as the resolution of the keypad screen. In the case of INT-TSH2, it is 1024 by 600 pixels. The pictures for the INT-TSG2 slideshow should have a lower resolution, namely 480 by 272 pixels. Graphics can be prepared using any graphics program having an appropriate function. However, in order to facilitate the work of installers, at SATEL we have created the Picasto program. It is a special tool that speeds up the adjustment of graphics to the required resolution. The program is very easy to use and can be downloaded directly from our website. Okay, if the photos are already prepared, you need to upload them to the memory card removed from the keypad. These files can simply be copied into the Photos directory. Another way is to upload these files using the DLoadX program. So I go back to configuring. I select the Micro SD Card tab, move to the Slideshow tab. Here we can add and remove images. Finally, those that have been prepared can be saved to a memory card connector to the computer. Next to the slideshow, there is another tab described as Sounds. Here we can add sound files that will be associated with selected zones. This means that when a selected zone is violated, the keypad will play the uploaded sound. However, be careful here. Chime signaling with the use of MP3 or WAV files is available only for the INT-TSH2 keypad. This is because the INT-TSH2 has a built-in speaker, whereas the INT-TSG2 uses a piezoelectric transducer. Let's move to the Screen tab again. From the screensaver, I move to the tab labeled as 1. This is the first of the user screens. We can give it any name. We see that the name we have entered is displayed at the top of the screen, in the middle. To the left of the name, you can see icons indicating the system state. On the right is the clock and an icon, which can be tapped to log a user in or out. With the default settings, the first screen contains icons for macros to arm the system in various modes or to disarm it. We will tell you more about how to create and edit macros in the next episode. Below are three icons that can be used to quickly trigger one of three alarms: panic, fire, or auxiliary, medical. Next to them, you can see the information widget icon. As you can see, there is a field here in which you can enter any content. It will be displayed after clicking this icon on the keypad screen. By default, only three dots are entered here. Instead, the installer company data or the name of the maintenance technician may be entered. Okay. I will not make any other changes to this screen. To create another one, I click the plus button at the top right of this window. As you can see, there is an additional tab relating to the newly created screen. I remind you that there can be a maximum of 8 at this menu level. Okay, so now I move on to the new screen. On the left, under the field where we can change the screen name, you can see the percentage indicator of remaining memory available for the screens and the elements placed on them. Now let's look at the options available next to it. If you check the Home screen box, this screen will be displayed first, right after switching from the screensaver. And from it, we will be able to move sideways to other user screens. The next field is Available after logging in. This option should be checked if you want a given screen and the widgets arranged on it to be available only to logged-in users. The two lower fields are related to the appearance of the screen. The Show grid option may be useful if we want to visually divide the screen and arrange the elements we add accordingly. The grid can also be used as an aid when we are placing the items on the screen. Then, after arranging them, you can hide the grid. On the other hand, if you uncheck the Use Theme option, you will be able to change the set of colors and the background image for a given screen. This works the same way as we discussed earlier in the case of Screensaver. To make the everyday operation of the system convenient and clear, you can set, for example, the plan of the entire property or the building as the background of the user screen. You can then arrange on it, among others, armed partition state and detector state indicators, or icons relating to the control of various system elements in different parts of the object. This will facilitate navigation and finding functions, which you just want to call. I would like to remind you, however, that if we change the background image on the screensaver or user screen to our own graphics, we will no longer be able to select other custom graphics for other screens added in this way. It will be different in the case of additional screens, but I will tell you more about this in the next episode. Let's now see what items can be added to the user screen. The list includes widgets which we discussed while talking about the screensaver, namely text, partition, zone, and output status, temperature, date, time, and rectangle. The Panic, Fire, Auxiliary, and Information widgets are the widgets we have just mentioned for the first user screen. The remaining widgets are Switch, Macro, and Link. But we will discuss details of these widgets in the next episode. That's all for now. Thank you for your attention and welcome to the next eAcademy episodes. See you soon.